Hello, welcome to my next episode of Don't Starve Shipwrecked. So we got the volcano stuff's happening right now, so we're gonna make some food to prepare for that. And we're going to try and stave off anything bad happening. Alright, there's two ways we can do this. There's a method where we're gonna go out into the harbor and we're gonna dodge that way. We'll need this. And then there's the method where we're going to actually dodge it on land. There's a couple things to remember for each method. When we go out to harbor, this used to work really well. Reason being, you actually could not be damaged by meteors while in a boat, the falling eggs. Now you can. And they also used to do 10 times more damage, basically. It would one hit you no matter what. But now it doesn't. So, what that means is... What that means is you can actually get hit in this boat since it has 417 right now. I can actually get hit and survive, which is really good. But I don't want to get hit, obviously. But I can, and I would survive. And on the ground, if you're wearing armor, you can get hit and survive. If you have good armor, you can get hit a couple times. But we're going to have to be dodging waves, so we want it to be kind of right here. And you absolutely, under no circumstance, want to be anywhere close to your base for doing this. So we haven't had anything happen yet, so I'm going to kind of, like, get seaweed and explore a little. I'm going to start my exploration today anyway. So I might as well just kind of bounce with what I have. And I'll get away from, yeah, I want to be in the shallow water for this. There's a couple things to consider. One is, if it's late at night, you won't be able to see the incoming meteors, because there won't be any light if you're on the ocean. So you absolutely need a boat torch or a boat lantern. Preferably a boat torch, it has a much bigger range. So that's the one thing you're going to need, unless you can find bioluminescence like the ones right here. But these don't illuminate very far. So... if you're using just these, you might not be in a good situation. Where is that shark? They're up here somewhere. All right, here. It's only rumbled once, so it's gonna rumble again. There we go. And then the third time is gonna start it. So after the second time, we absolutely want to be on the ocean for this method. The other method is going to be staying on land but being far away from every building. That method has advantages and disadvantages. The major advantage is you can actually easily carry a torch or have a light or a lantern or something like that, or if you have an obsidian fire pit, you can use that. It's a pretty major advantage. And also, when the rocks drop, some of them will stay or make magma pools, and you can use ice on those magma pools to make obsidian, which is a great way to get obsidian. And the rocks that stay, you can mine them for flint and other stuff. And these are all going to fall in the ocean, so they won't. One of the disadvantages of this method is if our boat gets hit and destroyed, we will drown and die. Unless we have either a meat effigy stone set up or we're wearing a life jacket. I'm wearing a life jacket. It's advised that you have one of these if you're going to do this method. It's probably going to start around the beginning of next day. As the season goes on, it'll get more intense. So it's really not intense right now. But as the season goes on, it'll get more intense. So what I'm doing is I'm kind of just exploring the map while this is happening. Because I really, really don't want this to happen. That's like a huge light radius. I don't want this to happen while I'm on land. That'll kill my base. Because what the rocks will do is if they land on your base, they'll destroy it. But also they have a chance of either making a magma pool, shattering, or staying. And if they make a magma pool, magma pools, like an open campfire, will light things close to them on fire. Including, all right, so we're getting pretty close now. It might actually happen before daylight. They'll light your base on fire, basically. Not only will they destroy it, but they'll light it on fire, which will destroy the rest of it. So you really don't want to be anywhere near your base. As the season goes on, it's only going to get worse. But there's ways to appease it, but we have to find a volcano to do that. Alright, so here's the edge of the world. I'm going to start tracing this because it's so close to here. We don't want to be at all close to far away from shallow land, because when it starts happening, we got to get there pretty fast. We don't have to, but there's going to be tidal waves from the meteors hitting the water, and that'll damage our boat heavily and soak us. And we want to avoid those if we can. And it's much easier if there isn't waves going in every direction. So I just used this time to uncover the map to be safe. You definitely have plenty of time in the earlier season. You could leave well after the third one. But late in the season, you will not be able to do that. Once you hear the third one, I mean, you have to be, like, on your way out of your base. Or bad stuff starts to happen. So we know the volcano, and there's probably not going to be much here, but I still like to uncover the whole map. Ideally, eventually, I'll have the whole map, like, line by line uncovered. I'm pretty close to the shallows over there. That's probably where I'm heading. And I don't want to go near this other boat because I can't. Okay, see. We hear this. So what's going to happen is that we can see the shadows. Now. If this hits me, it's going to destroy my boat in two hits. Well, actually, one hit almost. But it's pretty easy to dodge on the ocean, I feel, because you're really fast. Though you do have momentum-based movement, which can be difficult. As long as you keep going, you can turn on a dime. But if you stop, you could be screwed. Alright, and this ash comes by to indicate that this is happening. Alright, now that's over. We're pretty safe. We're going to put on the chilled amulet, and it's going to cool us down. And we're going to head back to our base. These ashes will stop eventually. This can make it a little bit difficult to dodge the ashes. We'll get more food, and then we're going to go out. And explore some. And also you're degrading your boat by being on the ocean, which is not good, obviously. So those are the disadvantages of going out to sea. Next time we'll probably do it on land, so you can see that. This makes it quite difficult to see, but it's over now. If you find one of these biomes, it'll actually cut these trees, which is kind of good. This is too close to our base, though. And now we want to keep this on, because there's always a chance that it happens again when we're gone, and we'll want this. This will count as a fish, I believe, and a meat, but it might not. That might be crazy. We're gonna grab our booty pack. It did not count as. It has to be a bigger, I guess. Alright. This is good enough right now. And what we need is a fishing rod so we can get stuff. We have our chilled amulet, and we have this, so we're good to go. And now we're time. It's time to explore. Actually, maybe I should fix the sail. Yeah, I'll need to fix the sail. I don't need to, but if I plan on spending it a couple days out at least, so it's gonna be good to have that full sail. And this, I'll eventually have to take this off if it gets too in disrepair. All right, monsters here, monsters there. I'm going to explore this area over here a little more. Eventually, we're going to want to try and find every watery grave. The reason being is that's how we get one of the keys to help Woodlegs out. And if you're not lucky enough to find it in the first couple, you're going to have to eventually open all of them. So we're going to go through and try and basically explore every inch of this ocean. It's a tedious task, but it's, I believe, a really good task to do during the season. Because of what I've explained so far, it's something you can definitely do during a... This season, because the meteors, you can dodge them on the ocean, and there's very, very little nighttime, so you don't have to waste your boat torch. And if you find bioluminescence, you can just chill there for the night very easily, not waste a lot of time. And you don't want to be around your base when something like this happens. Okay. I agree. So, what I did in the original playthrough, I'm going to do again in Reign of Giants, and that is outline the world right here. I'm just going to go at this angle across this and not go in it. And when we get to the corner, we're going to do the same thing, and that'll basically tell us our boundaries. And then we can go explore all the close spots. And we might be able to see the edges of stuff like this, and we'll know that there's something here, right? We know that's a coral reef, but actually I'm gonna dip in because yes, brainy sprout, perfect. I wanna explore this to make sure, oh, two brainy sprouts, perfect. Brainy sprouts are really good. They asked to make the brain hat. I don't know if we can actually just look at it. No, we can't. The brain hat is actually pretty dope. And this provides us free light for the night, too. Those are close to our... So we have a good base area. It took me a long time to find that area, but it's good. Okay. Boom. Free light. Now we just chill. We could pick these, but they go bad super fast, and we're not going to be back soon enough for it to actually benefit us to do so. So we won't. But they're so close to our island, we can pop by, get two, go back, make two brain hats. And the reason I explored this is because we're really looking for the Yarctopus, too, because he has a couple things we need. So we want to try and get him if we can. And I just don't want to waste my boat lantern because I'm in the dry season and I might need it at night to not get murdered by the dragoon eggs falling, the meteors. I call them meteors, dragoon eggs, or volcanic rocks. You're just going to have to get used to that because there's just no way I'm going to call them the same thing every time. So those, I want to save my light radius because my light radius will get smaller as my lantern goes down. I didn't mean to do that, but I just did, so it's happening. And I'm not going back because it's going to cost sanity. So I guess we're exploring down here now? Yep. We'll explore up here. All I remember when I first got shipwrecked, I had no idea what was on the edge of the map at all. So I was like, can this just go on forever? Can it be magical? Nah, can't. Can't be magical like that. There's no way. Design-wise, there's no way it can go on forever. But I had a dream. The only way to actually explore past some of this is to actually, like, go in and, like, dip in. And I'm not doing that, so. Alright. I don't want to go against the waves that much. So I'm just going to go down a little bit like this. Cut this off. Cut this out. Kind of. And then I'm going to come back. We have a nice raft down there. There's some coral. Next time I go to a coral reef, I might grab some. Alright, let's go back down here a little. So I'm kind of like looking at the map, also kind of looking at not running into waves. Normally I would just be like looking at the map every now and then to make sure I didn't leave any little spots. It's just a pet peeve of mine is to have like one tiny section unexplored. We got a cool, even though we're not too hot now, still we're not overheating, we're still cooling down actually, because there's this long time when you don't have the symptoms of overheating, but you're still hot. So I'm just making sure I give myself enough time. Okay. Nothing in here. I just want to make sure there's no, like, extra watery graves. Because it's, like, a really easy thing to miss. It's, like, the octopus watery grave, stuff like that. Island's kind of hard to miss, but... And it'd be really great to find the volcano. We can't do much in the volcano right now. Like... With what we have on us, we can't really do anything, really, but eventually we're going to basically need to find the volcano, so. See, like, these are little things you could absolutely miss if you weren't exploring every inch. And you can find some pretty good stuff in here. Like, you can definitely have dumbrellas and stuff. Like, a sewing kit, that can be crucial when the game begins, because you have no houndsteeth. So that's why that's another reason I just want to explore every little inch, is because stuff like that. You can find a dumbrella in a steamer trunk. That used to be their only, like, location. You just had to hope you'd eventually find one. So right now, basically, we know the volcano's, like, over here. Right? Because this is the edge of the world on this side. This is the edge on that side. We got the edge up here. So, it's probably not here, it's probably not here, it's probably down there. So I'm going to head down that way. I'm just trying to explore as much as possible. Later we can make some pirate hats for exploration. It'll make us explore a lot more, but we don't want to do that in the dry season because of the overheating. We really want to wear our umbrella as much as possible. It'll prevent us from overheating. It can't actually cool us down, but it prevents our heat change a good amount. Oh my god. It's like impossible to dodge like when you're going against it like that. Yeah, just unfortunately, this is the kind of direction I have to go in. Alright. So we're having another eruption here. After this one, if we're anywhere close to home, we could go home. Go back to our base to get more food and stuff. This is another season like summer and winter that are really important to have food on you. Like, ready to make in your fridge or something, because you don't want to have to worry about food, because during an eruption, you obviously can't go back and get food. You'd have to, like, pick seaweed or something, and it's risky, so. It's since we've already found basically everything we need to on an island, there's really no point to me like exploring islands at this point. We know where the Seaworthy is. It's right there. Actually really close to our island. Seaworthy. Slot machine. If the Yarctopus is right here, by God, we have the shark den. Everything's around our island. It's actually really cool that that turned out like that. The Yarctopus is probably going to be on the other side of the map. If the volcano is right near our island, too, it'd be perfect. But since we know where everything on an island basically is, we don't know where the things are. They're probably on one of these random islands. It's not really important to me that I find islands right now. I'm really just looking for the volcano. And the Yarctopus. Those are the two things I haven't found yet, the two major things. Yeah, this is absolutely a step you can skip, by the way. Like, you don't need to know where the edge is. You don't have to have it revealed at all. I'm just doing this because I like it that way. Right, like, you can just know where the edge is. I can see it's gonna be right here, right? And then, like, for here, it's going to be right here. But I like to do it anyway. I will come in a little bit to see if there's anything cool. Bioluminescence, perfect for the night. Might as well not waste boat lantern if we don't have to. I got a second life jacket. So I'll come in and I'll kind of circle around exploring some of this black area. And then go back and stay the night. And then after this eruption, we need to go home. So we need to kind of set our course that way. I don't want those dicks to attack me, though. And this is perfect, because it's, not... There's no waves here, and we don't want to get hit by waves, obviously. And I know I said I want to see the bottom, but I'm going to cut across here, see if I see anything interesting, and then loop back in. Because the thing's gonna happen sometime midday the next day, and I want to get back and get food and like maybe one banana pop. So I'll cut across. I can explore the edges at any time. That's an ultimate goal of mine, is to explore everything, but it's not a goal that I need to accomplish in the first 100 days or some crazy shit, or the first year. It's a goal that's just like this thing that, hey, we haven't explored this, let's go explore it. So alright. Figures that we have the waves in this direction now. Okay, we're gonna head back. So I'm perfect. And boats just really don't last long. That's another thing. It's like, it takes so long. These boats, like, just go wicked quick. Let's go see what's down here. That sounded promising. I don't know if this will actually hit. Oh man. I don't know if the meteors will like knock these rocks off. So that could be an interesting thing to figure out. Otherwise, the coral field would be really good because you'd be mining coral while doing all this stuff. Alright, no Yarctopus. Which is actually probably a good thing because we want to find him. But if we do find him, we want him to be closer to our base. So seeing that he's not as far away is good. Okay, we're approaching the volcano. That's why it's zooming out like that. And we can actually climb up and go in. just zoom to my advantage briefly. I'll retrieve this. Power coast. Alright, we got the key though. Boom. Wet bone key. Machete and rock. Need ice or shade. Alright, well, I don't want to leave my backpack, so let's get over here a little, away from the fire coast. And we'll knock 5% off here. I shouldn't do that. And then we're heading back home. Alright, volcano? Kind of far from us, right? A little bit of a map, a little bit of a trek, but if we, like, go boom, I mean, not that far. Alright, we'll just take that little sanity hit and just hit right here or so. Next to this island, and we should be pretty close. Or we could just go from here and come on over. Both are pretty good options. Okay, that's a third eruption. That means it's coming soon. We don't want to be around these dicks. And I'm going to explore that some other time. Actually, these guys will fuck off if we can explore that. And we can test this hypothesis. Let's see what happens when I'm in here. If these guys will leave. They should leave, because they're being kind of disingenuous right now by doing this. I would like you to leave now. I've gone pretty far from where you originally found me. Alright, there we go. And after, I'll just hop in that. We'll see where it brings us. I have the sanity to spare right now. Actually, let's go in here for brief. Because the eruption isn't happening. It's going to be pretty short when it does happen. Oh, these guys again. I think this might be an island. Oh, it looks like an island. Yeah, I need to repair my boat too. Because it's just falling apart. Which means I need to get back. There's another island right here real quick. I don't want to, like, devastate these islands. That's why I don't want to be close to them. Starting a fire on an island is not a great idea. I don't know where the other bird is. This, what's it called? Doidoy? I don't know where the other doidoy is. That's another thing I have yet to find. And if he's on an island and I start an impromptu forest fire on the island, that could kill him. Okay. Now we head back. We should be able to get back by end of the day. Drop stuff off and repair our boat before we leave again. If we get another eruption real quick, we're just gonna do the land method. I have to explore these. Like, I legit have to. So I don't have to freaking come back to all of them. A big one. Very octopusy right now. Usually he's in a pretty big one. No, but we got a brainy sprout, which I'm gonna grab. It's gonna start dying fast. Does not last long. That would have been like the ideal one to have the octopus into. Now what we can do is we can actually hit the volcano. Oh my god, if this is the volcano one, that's gonna be perfect. I'm coming back to that first thing. See? Already. Like these limpets we've had for a while. Look how fast this is. I think it's like a couple days, actually. I think it might be like 2 days to spoil. Torch out. There we go. Are you trying to kill me or something? He's trying to come at me? Oh, he was trying to come at me. He should know better. I'm not to be trifled with. Alright, let's pop this baby in here. We're gonna do this. Some ice for banana pops and other stuff. We don't need to do the watery graves, so I'm gonna keep this on me. This is like my misc stuff. And over here is my bottles and cloths. See how everything's organized? That's what I was talking about last time. It's lovely and I love it. This can go in here, it's extra. We'll drop this machete. And our keys can go in here. Actually, is this taken? Gold keys. Same diff. And I also want to make some meatballs, which I'll need these for, and seaweed. Cook, please. I need to drop this in here. Alright, there we go. Some bisque. I don't need actually a second life jacket. Now that I have this one. And rot. We have to take a guess. Rot was in here. I knew it. I knew it all along. We got pierogies, because the eggs. I am okay with pierogies. Have those still. Banana pop. Ice. Two sticks. Bisque. Oh, we at home, so guess what? Cool ourselves down, man. Doesn't sound good. We're at one. Must be alert of these things at all times. We are at one. DEFCON 1. I repeat, we are at DEFCON 1. Seaweed. 2, 3. Ah, shit, it turned my thing off. No! I hate it when that happens. I guess it wasn't close enough to this, but it's close enough to that. I'll have to, like, reposition. I really want to put this right here, but I have to get rid of the chest first. Maybe I'll be able to fit right here, and then I'll be able to put the chest in the middle. Because game mechanics, don't ask questions. That's how things fit, I guess. That'll be a I have extra time type thing. These are all like withered again. And I don't want to turn it on because it's going to take that, turn that off. We have more meat. Yes. Get it. Boom, boom, boom. Alright, brainy sprout. We're looking at this. Brain hat. thought. Hey, jellyfish and rope. I'm not doing that. So we eat it. Yum. Get a hunger and sanity from that. I don't have a jellyfish right now. I don't really want to go get one, so that's why I'm not doing that. I don't have enough ice. Never mind. Actually, probably do this. I don't know if this is enough fish. It won't be, I don't think. It's probably going to make goop. Okay. I need one more. Right? Great recipe. What's happening? As long as you one-on-one these guys, you good. Oh, shit. Uh-oh, this guy will get pissed if I do this. And you can't be close enough to hide for them to flip out. For obvious reasons. They are disinterested. Okay. I made some magic. What'd I make? Ratatouille. Perfect. Why not? Hey, what's up? That guy's still angry. Now I need this, and I need some shovels, which I don't have. To go like this because we cooled down. And we gotta, we need boards now. Oh man. At least these are the right maturity stages for me to cut down. I need boards for a boat repair kit. Alright, numero dos. Okay, so let's drop this in here, and we're gonna need this. Two meatballs, got plenty of these right now. This goes to tree chest, this goes here, we're good on that right now, we can't go fishing yet, we're good on this. We do need our chilled amulet, we want this in our inventory. I need some ice. If I'm gonna do a strike on land, I always wanna have ice on me. I just want to get ice, so I want to stay here. But I'm gonna need to leave. What should I have? Cause the third one's gonna come pretty soon. Yep. We out. Absolutely not near your base after the third one. You have no idea how long it's gonna be. Unless you have some mod or something that tells you you're crazy and you've memorized it. Alright. So what we have right here is a fucking every bad thing happening at once situation. And I don't have my armor on me. So So I'm gonna pile onto this, and I absolutely cannot go back now to get my armor. So we're going to make a grass suit, which we actually can't make with the shit we have on now. Alright, so what my goal is right now is to not get absolutely fucking murdered. How I'm gonna do that is I'm gonna run around in circles until the meteor strike happens. And I'll hope some of the meteors will hit these guys. I can't fight them because they will win. There's just no way. I would have to get them one at a time, and I don't have a road, and I'm not going very fast. I don't have any coffee or anything to speed boost me, or I'd be able to try and skill this. And even if I do try and fight them, there's a good chance that, like, the second I do, the meteors will come down and, like, land on me while I'm stun locked or some shit. These trees are gonna get messed up, by the way. Okay. Please. Alright, there we go. If I was really confident, I could try and kite one of them into a blast, but that would be a bad idea. Poor decision. Because they will one-hit kill me with no armor on. Okay, caught on fire. It'd be sometimes hard to see the shadows with that coming up. Okay. I don't want to attack the hounds. I'm very focused on where the shadows are landing so I don't die. Alright. Okay, so I don't want to do two of them either. These are going to hatch pretty soon. And my hounds are going to be interested in that. Alright, let's prevent these from hatching if I can. Where's the last ones? Fish morsel. I might have gotten them all. Not really sure. Right? Free obsidian. Obsidian's hard to get. These will eventually just burn out, by the way. But this is a appropriate way to get obsidian. Done. Okay. So we're at one. Count them. DEFCON 1. And so on. Repeating till the end of the season. Until we can go appease the volcano, which I think we might actually be able to do this time. I'm going to get back to my base, and we will reconvene in the morning. All right, rock stuff, hound's teeth, and this. I really just needed this. Is why the whole reason I kind of had to be here for a while. Alright, magic stuff. Let's put this away right now. I guess this is just producing ice, like it's not even a thing. So, I guess this is just things like try-harding the ice right now. Thank you, Mr. Ice. Seriously, is this like glitched or some shit? The ice machine that could? I mean, if it's gonna give me free ice, I'm gonna go do this. See how everything's devastated and there's like 10 times less stuff? That's because this happened. This was no good. Oh yeah, a whole boat repair kit for almost nothing. Oh yeah. I can eat ice when I'm getting hot. Since I guess my ice machine is jammed on or something. Which is a really cool glitch if it's a glitch. If you could reproduce that, that would be dope. Alright, so I got a brainy sprout right here. I got two right there. Is there one right here? There isn't. And there's none right there. It'd be really cool if it was right by there for the sanity gains. In the next season... Oh, shit. I gotta end this episode. I just don't want my episodes going for hours. So this is gonna be the end of this episode. Next episode, we're going into the volcano, so it's super exciting. So if you've never played the game before, you have to watch the next episode now because this is what you've been waiting for. Volcano is really epic. Alright, I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, you can like, subscribe, or comment. If you leave mean comments, I will respond to them. and I encourage you to do so. So, I hope you're enjoying this Let's Play series. I'm going to try and work on my other ones this week. I got some free time this week, so I'm really going to try and work on as much stuff as possible. Alright, see ya. Have a good day.